Is pulsing. I'm a blood-sucking venture capitalist and a full-time truck driver. And I drive. I like to drive around the country, parking my trailer in the back of cool places like Clutch Studio. I bring my better half, my polar bear of a dog, and we're just trying to find and fund the best hustlers that we can. So we're coming to Wichita the first week of December. We're gonna be hanging out there, having a good time, and. I don't know. You know, the best way to describe what I am and what we are the Cousin Eddies of the tech world.
Yes.
We're out here filming for Quince by Melissa, shooting some product and lifestyle photography as we update their website and update their brand. So exciting stuff.
Going down this week. Let's go. Great job. That's what I'm talking about. It's going down this week. Be ready. Tuesday. We just get started. October 25th. Look at that.
Yeah. Yeah, they're doing it right. Good profit. I haven't read all of it, but I've read some of it and the parts that I did.
So write that shit down. Let's figure out where the hell. What's up, dude?
Good to see you, baby.
Good to see you. Good, good, good. Thomas, Nate, Thomas. Thomas is our video guy.
Nice to meet you.
He does just records us all day. Nice. Michael Ward.
How's it going? Patient
with him. Yeah, nice to meet you as well.
Later, bro.
Whoa! Let's go!
We're currently doing two different events. One of them is Vote the Mob by Armando Mijares and the Seed House. Clutch Studio is actually going to document what's going on. It's actually right next door to where we're actually located currently. And then we're also going to go to Shocker Startup. The Wichita State University has invited me back to go and speak to a couple of different individuals about entrepreneurship and being willing to fail. Stay tuned.
The other generation is voting, and I think seeing all these youth out here is just saying the younger generation is taking a step forward, making their voices heard today.
What do you say to them when they say that they shouldn't go out and vote or that it's just a waste of time? What do you say?
I mean, you know, they're entitled to their decision and their, you know, their opinions, but I, as someone that can't vote, is just like, be my voice, you know, be there, be at the polls for me. Sounds a little selfish, but try to make all our futures collectively brighter and take a new step into it. You could be the one that changes everything. You know, one vote can change the world, you know?
So vote, Bob. We're here October 25th. Got Armando Mincares, got Rudy Love. Got a couple of other musicians that'll be out here. Be sure and stay tuned. We got a documentary that we'll shoot with a couple of interviews. If you need anything, make sure you hit us up on the blogs, YouTube, clutchstuds.io.
Generation, it has to happen this way. We're born and bred this way. We're supposed to go through these hardships so that way, whenever it's we do hit that success level, that we feel like it's success. It's not money. It's not none of that stuff, bro. It's just our sense in ourselves of, I want to be successful. What do I want to be to be successful? I want to be able to be happy and be able to have this, right? And that only comes from us inside. Yeah, you only know it by us ourselves.
Yeah, on your definitely.
Visually seeing all that stuff, bro.
Or you can come out.
When you take the risk, when you make the jump, you gotta go against everybody. Everybody's gonna be against you. Every single human being, whether they love you or they don't love you, subconsciously they don't understand what's going on inside your head, and they're not supposed to, because it's for you. It's for nobody else but yourself.
Or when people are in pursuit of happiness,
real, truly,
they're trying to do specific things that they like.
And that's what I feed off of, bro. When people doubt me, bro, that gives you the fuel that you need to know that, okay, if they're doubting, that means that they don't believe it can be done. But their beliefs aren't the same as my beliefs. You know what I mean? And you learn from everything. That's why you have to be willing to fail, because you always learn. You always learn. Ask Thomas. The first time he got a lens, the only way he really truly learned how to mess with it was by messing up. Right or wrong,
he says
you can play around with a damn freaking lens all you want.
You want to take,
and then you eventually like start finding your own niche on how you want to play with it. And you're like, okay, I'm gonna do it like this. So we're at Wichita State University, Devlin Hall, about to speak to the Shocker Startup community. Be sure and stay tuned. Be willing to fail. Los to Workaholic, Clutch Studio. There's nothing that I'm doing up here that none of you guys could do yourselves. I'm just taking the risk, right? I'm the one that's stepping up and willing to fail. Maybe trip and fall on my face, right? But I took that step. So there's nothing that I'm doing up here that you guys couldn't do. A couple other things. I want to drive home that if you start off thinking that you have to have the same story as me, that you have to have the same background as me, that you have to have gone through the same types of things that I've gone through in order to become successful, I need you to erase that from your mind. I'm simply a humble servant trying to be the voice of individuals who aren't willing to step up here and tell you exactly what it is that they're currently doing in their life. I'm honored to have several individuals in this room that have impacted my life more than they know. Every day that I wake up and my feet hit the ground, I know my purpose and my why. And I get to walk through the world expressing how much I love life. I look at all the blessings every single day when I wake up before I walk out of my door. I've got 7 children and a Yorkie, plus a beautiful wife. I get to look at them in the eyes as I make them breakfast before they go to school. I know how blessed I am, because 15 years ago, my entire life was headed in a downward spiral. The number one thing that helped me to overcome all of the adversity that I was going through in my life was knowing that my life had a purpose. Was finding that, taking time to myself and saying, what do I really want in life? The number one thing you need to remember is there's no excuses. None whatsoever. If I see you 5-10 years from now and there's an excuse in your repertoire or your vocabulary, you've got to remember that I told you that I've overcame some of the worst adversity that you can think of. You yourself have your own story. And if you don't like what you're currently doing, or you don't like where you're currently at, change it. Why would you stay in one place that you dislike and then go out and do the one thing that you can, that you only have one other option. If you don't jump and take that risk and are willing to fail, your other option is complaining. So those individuals that come to you and are complaining about how they hate to be at this job because it takes up so much of their time and they hate to be doing the things that they're doing because of this and this and that, those are the individuals who don't want to take that risk and don't want to jump and aren't willing to fail. And it's a process. And don't ever forget history of things that have happened to get you where you're at. So we just got done with the Shocker startup at Wichita State University. I'm humbled and honored to have the opportunity to speak to individuals who are interested in hearing the crazy stuff that I got to say. All I know is I'm trying to continue to spark creativity. I'm trying to continue to bring value to individuals. And I want to make sure that everybody understands that Clutch Studio is here for the people. We're here for all artists. We're here to bring value to every single human being that's in the Wichita as well as national level. Stay tuned, we got a lot of things coming. I think the vlog is gonna have too much footage for Thomas to edit, but it's okay. We like to go to the next level every single time.
I lived in a neighborhood for years, literally a block and a half away. Man, my cousin was just so happy to be moving up the street right over here, and the same owners that own the building, you know.
I used to be like, babe, I can't. Like, you are our coffee house. You, I can't speak for you. And then he would even, I mean, you can't take that and put it like you did
right
there. That's right. It's
yeah,
that was awesome.
Man, thank you guys. Love, brother. Telling you,
awesome. It's love, and it's just us being able to go against the grain of what everybody else is doing and the profit and all that. Like that shit. I mean, that's a second. That's
it'll come. It's provided for, brother.
Oh shoot, that's dope. Yeah. Good thing you didn't catch me with my pants all the way down like they normally are. The homeboy was taking solid. Yeah,
great meeting with our very good friend MowerPro.co, Kurt Reeves. Special shout out to him, entrepreneur in the Wichita community trying to start his own business. Be on the lookout for him, MowerPro.co. We were about to go have some lunch. It's been a long week, a little bit stressful week, I'm not gonna lie. We've got the new move that's coming up this weekend. Got everything set up, got the internet going.
Got that new office.
Got the desk already set up. Got the, be on the lookout for Trimworks. Who's building, custom building our desk for us at the new spot. 416 South Commerce, Suite 106. Be ready for the grand opening at the end of November. Don't forget, we also got Paul Singh coming. Tech Tour 2016. Be sure and check out that Airstream. The last night in the studio, we're packing up and headed to the new one, 416 South Commerce. Be sure and check us out. We're right across from the Interest Bank Arena. I want to take a little bit of time to remind you that the week of November 28th and the 30th, we're going to be having Paul Singh and the North American Tech Tour 2016 in Wichita. That's right, Paul Singh is bringing his Airstream and his team to come check out Wichita. Be sure and make it. You want to be a part of it. You want to collaborate with us on making sure that he has the best time in Wichita. Reach out to us. Reach out to my boy, Michael Ward, m.ward at clutchstud.io. He's got tons of information for anybody who needs it. I also want to take a little bit of time as I reflect and I leave this old studio to give a special shout out to some of my boys. I'm humbled and honored to have such a great team behind me. My boy Thomas behind the camera, my boy James, my boy Paulo, my boy Michael, my boy Thad, my boy Tony, my boy John, my boy Bavin, and my boy Caleb. Everybody that's around me is here because they believe in what it is that Clutch is doing. So I want you guys to say goodbye to Clutch Studio and hello to the Clutch brand.
Pow! Shout out to Bad News.